How well does Microsoft's latest operating system run on Apple hardware? We're going to find out as we install Windows 10 on a 2015 MacBook Pro. Stay tuned. Installing Windows 10 on a new MacBook Pro is actually very easy. You need two things to get started: a USB drive with at least 4 gigs of space and the Windows 10 ISO. You should also back up OS 10 just in case. In OS 10, launch your preferred web browser and head to Microsoft's website to download Windows 10. We'll put the address down below, or you can just do a search for Windows 10 ISO. Once you have downloaded the file, you'll want to open up Boot Camp. Boot Camp will walk you through the process, including formatting the USB drive and installing the ISO files to it. Remember that your USB drive will be formatted during the process to remove any personal files that you do not want to delete. During the process, you will also be asked to set the partition to where Windows 10 will be installed. This is your choice. You can leave the majority to OS 10 if that is your primary OS, or give 200 gigabytes to Windows 10. You can also split it evenly. Remember, you cannot later resize the Windows 10 partition, so think this through. Otherwise, you will need to use a third-party app to adjust the partition, or through Boot Camp, delete the Windows 10 installation and start all over. Once a partition is set up, the computer will reboot. You'll hear that famous Apple gong and then a black display. Don't worry, it may take a little while, but you'll soon see that Microsoft indicator as Windows 10 begins to load. Now we are getting into Windows. You need to first select a partition to install the new OS. This step is very important, as you could accidentally format your OS 10 partition if you are not careful. Make sure you choose the Boot Camp partition. In this case, it is easy, as it is the last one and matches the 200 gigabytes I allocated during the initial setup. You'll notice that the text is very tiny due to the Windows drivers not yet scaling. We'll fix this later. The OS installer will walk you through the rest. Remember, if you do not have a Windows product key, you can skip entering it and it will still install the OS. You can use Windows 10 without buying it, you just cannot customize the look, and you will have a watermark on the lower right-hand corner. Installation can take upwards of 15 to 20 minutes. The computer will reboot a few times as it installs drivers and configures the apps. Finally, we are now in Windows 10. Boot Camp will now install its own application that always sits in the taskbar area to the lower right. Here is where you can switch back to OS 10 and enable the right click for the trackpad so that it behaves like a true Windows PC. Boot Camp will also install the Wi-Fi drivers and other hardware support for the MacBook Pro. Let's set up and update Windows before we start playing. The reason everything is so small is because the display scaling is off. This is an easy fix. Just head into Settings, Systems, Display, and move the slider to where you think it looks good. I find 200% is ideal for the Retina display. You can log off the system to finalize the settings. Next, go back to Settings and select Update and Security. Although this is Windows 10, you will need the necessary Intel graphics drivers to get rid of that UI stuttering and to optimize performance. Windows 10 will also grab all the latest security updates and antivirus file definitions for Windows Defender. Once completed, you can reboot the OS to install those updates. Now that the OS is in tip-top shape, you will still want to update the store apps, including some core components. Launch a store and tap the user icon. Go to Downloads and hit Check for Updates. You may see upwards of 25 apps that need to be updated, including the store itself. Don't be surprised if the store suddenly quits, as this is simply being updated. Windows 10 is now ready for the world. Surprisingly, everything works as it should with a MacBook Pro. Wi-Fi, audio, keyboard controls for screen brightness and volume also work. The Command key rightly brings up the Start menu. Even Cortana works as it should. You can even plug in an Xbox One controller and play the latest Halo Windows game from the store. Battery life is also excellent, often pushing past 10 hours on a single charge. Additionally, for traditional PC users, you can download a third-party app from GitHub to reverse the trackpad scrolling. Apple's trackpad scrolls one way, whereas PCs are reverse. Once you download and flip the settings, you will need to reboot for the setting to take effect. Remember, you can use Windows 10 without a product key for as long as you want, but you cannot change certain settings and you have that watermark. However, if you do want to register and buy a license, Microsoft made it very simple. Go to Settings, Update and Security, Activation, and pick Go to Store. This will open up the Windows Store, and here you can buy a Home or Pro license for $119 or $199, respectively. Overall, Windows 10 runs fantastic on the MacBook Pro 2015. Battery life is great, performance is outstanding, and there's nothing that doesn't work. Even the trackpad experience is quite solid. So that's Windows 10 on a MacBook Pro. If you're a Mac user, I highly encourage you to try it yourself. And if you're a PC user looking for a premium laptop, well, you can give this one a shot, but it may hurt your wallet. If you need more Windows 10 info, just head to Windows Central. We have you covered. Take care, everybody.